afternoon, Major General D.A. Chaturvedi. We are very pleased to host you on Bazanath Leadership Web Talk Season 7. And it is a distinct pleasure to have somebody to represent Indian Army into the studio. A very warm welcome to you.
Good afternoon, Gayatri. Always a pleasure. Thank you.
So just for our audience, I want to tell that you are a highly decorated officer. You have the honors of Param Vishisht Medal, Ati Vishisht Medal, Param Vishisht Sena Medal, Ati Vishisht Sena Medal and Sena Medal. So very, very pleased to have you here with us. So just for all of our audience, you are the head of Territorial Army. And you have been leading the various amazing achievements that Ecological Task Force has had in India in restoring the natural ecosystems across. And that was one of the reasons why you were chosen to be honored with the Lifetime Achievement Award by Gaia the Earth Foundation as well. So without a further ado, I just want all of us to hear from you on how your journey started. And maybe you can help us take through the journey of Territorial Army and how it started in India and from where you joined in.
Thank you for your kind words, Gayatri. I don't think I deserve all of them. With regard to the Territorial Army and more specifically the Ecological Task Force, briefly I'll put across that it was in 1982 that the then Prime Minister, Mrs. Indira Gandhi, was advised by a German scientist by the name of Norman Borlaug that the only way to green the limestone quarried Himalayan ranges around the hill station of Mussoorie was to get the army to do it. And within the army, then it was decided by Mrs. Gandhi that the force will be created with the ex-servicemen. If the audience understands, it is all the retirees from the army. They were brought together, given some training, and then a battalion was formed with three companies, and they got to work in the characteristic manner. And within 5 years, the difference was felt, and after 8 years, the whole region could not be recognized. And why I can say this with conviction is that, I have done most of my education, that is the school education in Dehradun, and then my training at Indian Military Academy in Dehradun. And I have seen it, this transformation personally. And today, Mussoorie and the whole region enjoys much more rainfall, more snowfall, and lower temperatures. So it proved to be a boon for the Himalayan region there. And seeing the good end results, our country and various states within the country were motivated to raise more such ecological task forces in various states. So as of date, we have 10 ecological task force to include a composite ecological task force, Ganga, about which a little later. So the other 8 task forces are more in the state of J&K, there is one. In the state of Uttarakhand, there is one more in the area of Pithoragarh. Now, within the state of Uttarakhand, these two task forces, one at Dehradun and other at Pithoragarh, Dehradun and Pithoragarh, we joined hand, and it was the initiative of the present Chief of Defence Staff, General Rawat. He spoke to me, we discussed, and we decided that, we're going to plant 1 lakh of walnut trees in the border regions where, most of the hillmen were leaving that area because of lack of income. So to stop economic migration, we said, let us provide them with some kind of sustainable income without disturbing the environment. And this we could do with a shoestring budget, you know, over a year and a half, you know, right from getting the seeds, converting them into seedlings, getting those trees up to a year and a half, and then transplanting them in the regions, you know, ranging from 8,500 feet to about 12,000 feet.
Wow.
Then we have one in Rajasthan. Mm-hmm. The Jal Shakti Minister personally told me, the present Jal Shakti Minister, Mr. Shekhawat, he told me that he is impressed no end with their work because he's personally seen them green the desert. And then we have two of such forces in Assam, and we have only recently raised one force in the Marathwada region of Maharashtra.
Okay. And
there too, the government of Maharashtra was very keen, and we have a very, very good relationship with them. And we've been able to, within a short span of 2 years, been able to do some very, very substantial work on, you know, adding to the environment. But I could go on and on.
No, that's so exciting to hear these stories and how it has progressed over time.
Yeah.
So one of the things which is very impressive about your contributions to the ecological task force is the increment in the productivity. So I remember we having discussed this once before this, that earlier the amount of work that was done by one company, that is 100 people, of planting some 200,000 saplings over the span of 1 year, you were able to take it to the level of 500,000 saplings. So how did that increment happen? So that's more than two times, that's almost 2.5 times productivity increase.
You know, Gayatri, when I took over as the head of the Territorial Army, I was motivated to address the ecological task forces. And I viewed it, and I still view it as a global issue, not as a country-specific issue, not as a state-specific issue, not as a region-specific issue. So with that in mind, I said that let us contribute to the maximum level possible. Having thought that and, you know, discussed, debated, read, I came on to this model that let us you know, plant double, and as you said, you know, almost 2.5 times. So we came to a model actually, and we were also motivated by the fact that you know, carbon footprint is a major issue today, and the world is trying to reduce the carbon footprint, you know, to reduce the global warming. And we've not been able to, as a planet, not been able to really address it in a suitable manner till now. So decided that let us, of our own, you know, take initiative instead of waiting for someone to guide us and tell us what to do. So this model also came out of that thought. And, and the model is basically that you, you know, in a square meter of area, you, you plant four of the vetiver grass.
Okay.
Weeds, you know, to begin with. So vetiver grass, if you are aware, is, you know, endemic to India, and it has a characteristic, it, you know, develops very long, strong roots.
Yeah.
And in the process, what it does, it binds the soil, it, you know, holds water in its root, and most importantly, it sequesters carbon.
Right.
So broadly, you know, it sequesters one such vetiver plant sequesters 2.5 tons of carbon every year.
Wow. So one plant itself, or that one square meter of area in which
one plant. So and one tree, you know, does that one tree is, you know, about 10 tons in 1 year, one fully grown tree.
Right.
So we decided that let us, in a square meter area, let's plant these four vetiver grass plants. And also alongside we plant, you know, a tree.
Right.
Something. So now what happens is that in that 1 square meter, we are getting 10 tons of the carbon being sequestered after the first year.
Mm-hmm.
This we would have got after 5 years, actually, if we had planted
only a tree. A fully grown tree would have matured.
True. So this is the great advantage. And what we need to understand that this vetiver grass, you know, it propagates very fast. So in 1 year, that one twig becomes 10 times. That clump, it becomes the clump of 10 such twiggery thick. And so we also decided.
Yeah.
We have a model in place with which, you know, I have executed in the Territorial Army Eco Task Force.
Mm-hmm.
And I have requested them to follow it up. If it is followed up, then probably we would be able to sequester about 1.5 you know, billion tons or a little more by 2030. That is the year.
That's amazing, which, benchmark and amazing contribution by Indian Army to the Indian goals of, you know, achieving carbon emission targets.
Very true. You know, our national goal is 2.5
right.
billion tons. We were trying to hit that of our own, but we realized that no, you know, it is a little too ambitious for us. It's and even this 1.5 billion tons would require additional for people to be employed.
Right.
And some public effort also. That would happen in about 2025, 2026. Because this propagation will continue. The idea is that we take out, you know, five such, you know, twigs from or these plants from the 10, which is grown in 1 year, and replant them. And then they become again 10, and then they become again 10, like that. So that is how, you know, and each one of them is sequestering 2.5 tons. So that is how we've calculated. So there will be an exponential growth after 2025, 26, which will need to be handled by additional force. So this is the basic model. And
very impressive model, and I'm sure that I mean it will continue to progress at this rate, and by 2030 we are able to achieve the 1.5 billion target as you have foreseen.
I sincerely hope and believe that it will happen, and probably India would then be seen as a leader towards you know, sequestering of carbon. And we are naturally, you know, I again firmly believe that we Indians are firmly given to respecting the nature.
That's right.